Rachel Armentano. I'm going to show you how to make a textured collage out of just a granola bar box, a scissors, a piece of tin foil, and a glue stick. And that's all you need. So the first step is to take your cereal box or granola bar box or whatever kind of box you have. A box like that works better than cardboard. So one of these boxes that has like more like cardstock, and you're just going to unfold it and cut it down. And you want to cut a bigger piece. So mine was about, I just used the lines on the inside of the box and cut this rectangle. So I have a piece this big. You want to cut three medium shapes. Any shapes will work. They just need to be able to fit onto the rectangle, and then a few smaller shapes. So right here I have three kind of trapezoid medium shapes, and then I have about seven little triangle shapes. So I'm putting aside my extra cardboard. I'm putting aside my tin foil for right now because I don't need it. I have my rectangle base, my medium shapes, my small shapes. I am going to take my glue stick out, and I'm going to arrange these on here. I'm going to glue them down so that they're color side up. And I used three medium shapes because I really like things in threes. And three is actually a magic number when it comes to design. So I'm gonna put down three kind of trapezoidal shapes on here. And you can use a good amount of glue on there. This time I'm gonna glue brown side up. And what this does is it lets me see where my design is going so I can see the contrast. All this will get covered up so it doesn't have to be perfect. And I'm using a purple glue stick because I know that you guys can see the glue going on, which makes it helpful. So I'm gonna add these on top of my medium shapes. Step, what we're going to do is we're going to cover this in foil. So here is the very important trick. You're going to take your piece of tin foil. Now, if your tin foil has two sides, like one is more matte and one is shinier, I like to put the glue on the shinier side, but you can try both and see what you like. You are going to put a ton of glue on here. Like glue, 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 glue. You're gonna cover the whole section in glue, big enough that it would cover this piece of paper right here. So, as you can see, a little hard with my light here, but there's glue all over it, and the more the better. You wanna glide it across, you're not like smashing it. I am going to now take this, put it down on my tin foil. I want to trim down if you have a lot of extra. And I'm going to fold it along the back. You can make diagonal cuts in the corner. That makes it easier to kind of fold it. And I'm going to put a little extra glue on the back where it would fold over kind of like an envelope. So I'm just going to fold this. I can cut off or rip off any extra pieces. After I fold the back, I have this rectangle on the front, and this is hard to video because of the shine of the tinfoil. I'm gonna take either, you could do this with your finger. It works really well with a pom-pom or a cotton ball or a Q-tip. I'm gonna actually go in like a circular motion, and I think that you can see that. But as I start to press down and rub the front of it, my shapes are gonna come through. And I really am looking for where the shapes were stacked and going right around the edges of those, because that's where this is gonna show up the most. So you want those shapes. So cool. And then your design is
gonna show up well. What's really neat is you can also then take colored Sharpie, if you have some at home, and you can Sharpie right on the parts that are lifted. And that's how I ended up with this design. So this design, you can see that I have the same rectangle background, and then I have six squares, and then I did little pieces on top of them, but the exact same way that I did this. So you're just gonna cut out your pieces, you're gonna stack them, you're gonna glue stick them, you're gonna glue stick your tin foil, and then you're gonna wrap it up. Let me know if you give it a try.